This is a video about constructing equations and expressions, and we're going to start by talking about a doghouse. And you're wondering, why a doghouse? Well, when we talk about the story of X, we're really talking about how to build an equation or expression. So if I gave you a doghouse and I asked you to take it apart, let's say I wanted to repurpose it. Vintage is in right now, so I want to take it apart. How would you know how to take it apart? Well, it'd be easiest to take it apart if you knew how it was put together. So we can take things apart well when we know how they were put together. When we're talking about the story of X, we're really wondering how an equation was built. In other words, how is it constructed? How is it put together? So if we know how it was put together, then it makes it much easier to take it apart. Now you might be saying, how am I taking an equation apart? When we are solving an equation, say in this case right here, we are actually needing, when you solve an equation, we are actually taking it apart in order to figure out our final answer of X equals something. So we're not going to focus on how to solve it just yet. We're going to focus on how is it put together. So let's take a look at some terms that we're going to be using. Algebraic equation. This just means a mathematical sentence stating that an algebraic expression is equal to either a value, a variable, or another expression. The solution to an equation is the value or values that make the equation true. Equivalent equations obviously are two or more equations that have the same solution. And then inverse operations, you've probably heard this one before, really referring to opposite operations that undo each other. And we're going to be talking about this more when we talk about deconstructing the equation. And this lesson is going to really just focus on constructing right now. Okay, so let's take a look at this scenario for a minute. You're going to notice that as I go through this scenario, I'm going to underline things that are important. This is really crucial for kind of trying to dissect the information out of a story problem or a word problem. So it says a mixture for the ultimate chocolate milk calls for 5 scoops of chocolate. I think that could be important. You're trying to make a less chocolatey drink, so you decide to use 2 scoops less chocolate than the recipe calls for. In order to accommodate the number of kids you'll be hosting at a birthday party, you're also going to triple this modified recipe. So the first thing it asks us to do is to define a variable to represent the amount of chocolate the original recipe calls for. Again, we already know what that is because they told us it was 5 scoops of chocolate. So I'm going to use C for chocolate just because that makes sense. Again, you could use any variable, that really doesn't matter. B says write an equation that represents the known amount of chocolate in the original recipe. So right now I know that C equals 5, and that's 5 scoops of chocolate. C asks us to construct an equation, represent the series of mentioned alterations above to reflect the amount of chocolate used in the mixture when done. So remember, I know that it's using 2 scoops less, so I'm going to represent that by subtracting 2. So C minus 2 equals 5 minus 2 because I am taking off those 2 scoops of chocolate. So now I have C minus 2 equals 3. Next, it tells me that I'm going to triple this amount. So I know that I need to take this quantity and multiply it times 3. And likewise, take our now modified scoops of chocolate, now that's 3, and also triple it, multiply by 3, which is going to leave me with, when I simplify the right side of this, 2, 3 times the quantity of C minus 2, which equals 9. This means that I am using 9 scoops of chocolate in order to make the altered recipe. Now it says, what's the expression that describes the number of scoops of chocolate in the altered recipe? This is just going to be our expression on this side of the equation. So that 3 times the quantity of C minus 2. That's the expression, and remember, expression, we are not using an equal sign, so not using an equal sign. Then it says, suppose you begin with the ultimate chocolate mixture that used a different number of scoops of chocolate in the original recipe. You do the same alterations. The result is 12 scoops of chocolate. So now I want to use my same alterations but I'm going to end up with 12 scoops of chocolate. That's how I would write an equation that describes that situation. By the way, if you're curious, what does, so not in F, but back, if we go back to E for a second, what does our C represent here? Before you try solving anything or anything like that, remember, they already told us in our original problem that the our original C was 5 scoops. So we actually know that C equals 5 scoops of chocolate. Sometimes people are confused because they think that, oh, I need to solve for that C. You don't actually. Because again, you know that that's what we started with. This is why it's cool to know how the equation is built. I hope you found this video helpful, and now you're all set to try those practice problems in your lesson videos.